We are back with the Avenue Crockery School pub quiz. I meant Crockery
School. The Crockery School.
The Avenue Crockery School.
Alcohol burned to my brain.
Crockery School at Crockery School.
We have me, myself, Sophie Shalvey, your quiz master. We have, Crockery School. It's definitely not going to get tiring ever. Especially when it's done to yourself. And we have Neil Shalvey, aka Shanga, my husband, and Juan on his face.
Juan, it's really good.
No, yeah. Juan, you got now Juan.
Hello, Juan.
He's been nicknamed. He's got an alter ego, depends how much he's had to drink. And he's
well, how much I had, how much you had. He turned Julio into Juan. He's just.
What's going on? Hi, Juan, it's Julio.
I'm only little.
Don't worry, Julio, she didn't mean it.
And then we also have Richard Hotspur.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Yes, and he is currently the standing winner of the round so far. And
he's leading.
It's a mere 1 point.
It's a mere 1 point.
So,
I'm actually surprised by that.
What he's winning.
No, he's only winning by just a little bit.
Oh, you're so surprised he's winning. So there is a mere 1 point between them. And guys, it is a.
It's on like Donkey Kong.
It is on like Donkey Kong. They've been doing some press ups.
Yeah.
I mean, mind press ups. They've been sitting there drinking booze. It's a mind press up.
It's yes. I'm kind of at the stage where I think I might be made out of jelly.
So yes, we are going to proceed with the next round, which is fruit and veggies.
Get your fruit and veg.
And the way that it works, guys, is I will read the questions.
Yes.
For you all.
Y'all.
And eat for y'all. For y'all out there. And
am I right?
Moving on. So I will read the questions, leaving time for you all to write your answers. And at the end of each round, I will ask the contestants, Richard and Neve, their answers before giving the correct answers.
And we straight bourbon this round.
Guys, while you pour the drink, I'm going to start with the first question, which is, which vegetable can be oyster, chestnut, or shiitake?
That's a bit unfair.
Wow, that's the easiest question I think out of the whole lot. Number two, what ingredient is included in food in a Florentine style? What ingredient is included in food in a Florentine style? Okay, number three, what is the name for the removal of the green and white stalks of a strawberry? What is the name for the removal of the green and white stalks of a strawberry?
Guys, we know this. Congratulations and jubilation.
Number four, what nut does Waldorf salad contain?
It's a Waldorf salad, my dear fellows. And inside of the head is a nut, and you have to figure out what that nut is.
It's a naughty nut.
So, it is a naughty nut. It's not just a nut, it's a very good nut.
It's a nutty nut.
Yeah, sometimes I get nuts all over my nuts. No! Stop it, guys!
Stop it, Richard.
Okay, well, I gotta make a sign. It's all getting dangerous in here.
It is. How many vodka left?
That was a seriously bad throw.
Okay, guys, moving on. Number five. In an Indian restaurant, if you were served aloo, which vegetable would you be eating?
Oh, I know this.
We do. Number six. What do you call a bunch of bananas? That's quite a selfish.
A congress of bananas.
A congress? This is a great congress of bananas right here.
It's a parliament of bananas right there.
That's a very good question. I would always say a bunch of bananas.
Bunch of bananas, that's what I would say.
Well, it must be more sophisticated than that, wouldn't it?
Number seven. What dried fruit is a prune? What dried fruit is a prune?
Can I write it in Hebrew?
No. Because you could just tell me.
No, I just remember the name of the one in English. So I'm good.
Also, love. Can you just write it in Hebrew so Rich can try and read it?
I'll write it in Hebrewish, so I can write it. Yeah.
Number eight. The French term "mange tout" literally translates to what in English? Are you ready for number nine?
Can I sit with that?
Oh, you're in a bit.
What fruit is the main ingredient for a Melba sauce?
A what? A Melbourne.
What fruit is the main ingredient for a Melba sauce?
You said fruit. Can we get a colour?
Oh. Number 10. What is the first vegetable to be grown in space?
Oh god, I remember about this the other day.
The level of... I thought I was a foodie, but I'm getting less than 50%. Like,
this is what's interesting, is I painful. Also consider myself a foodie, but these are like obscure foodie questions. They aren't like technical food questions. This is what is kind of interesting.
I hope you guys are challenged.
Are you ready? Should we move on to the answers then, everyone?
Answer me.
Number one, which vegetable can be oyster, chestnut, or shiitake? Both say at the same time?
Sausages. Mushroom. Well, I said mushroom, but this is sausages. You don't get any points for that.
I definitely did not write. Right.
Okay,
my friends wrote mushrooms.
I assume you both wrote mushrooms, yeah. So you both get a point. Number two, what ingredient is included in food in a Florentine style? Shango.
Richard only wrote spinach.
And
yeah, well, he said eggs and spinach, but it is spinach.
It is spinach, Shanga. Obviously, it is right. So,
Shanga, you get the right because you wrote spinach.
But!
No, that's a full point.
God, eggs it's, Florentine.
Yeah, but the thing is, it's yeah, so eggs Florentine, so eggs, but you don't need the eggs. Yeah. But yeah, anyway, my nephew.
Number three. What is the name for the removal of the green and white stalks of a strawberry?
Decapitation.
Rich.
Decapitation. That pause was like, no! Not my head.
Richard
they
wrote,
put a sack over it before they did it.
Richard wrote, pluckety.
No, I said pluckety.
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 That sounds quite nice. Pluckety. I think a pluckety on my strawberry.
God, that's not a Y.
Yeah, it's pluckety.
Guys, well, you're both wrong anyway. It's called pollen.
Pollen.
Hello!
Not my favourite Friday.
All the girls are there. Hello!
Right.
Number four, what nut does Waldorf salad contain?
It's a walnut.
You're both right.
We know that.
The answer is walnut, in case you didn't hear through their very baritone voices.
Walnut. Very singing mouth.
Number five, in an Indian restaurant, if you were served aloo, which vegetable would you be eating?
I'm afraid, Shane, you got it wrong.
He went qualified.
He did.
I thought he might have. And the correct answer is potato.
Oh, Richard did write potato. How did you know that?
Because Jira Allen.
Number six. What do you call a bunch of bananas? Shango.
We just wrote a clap. A clap of bananas right there, girl.
Oh, I said a clasp. A clasp.
Oh, a clasp. No, that was also incorrect.
A group.
No, that is also incorrect. The correct answer is, in fact, a hand.
You mean hand of banana?
I almost
a
clasp. No, a clasp though.
No, it shouldn't.
It's a clasp.
It's amazing.
A clasp is the same as a hand. You know, a clasp is like that.
Goodness. I disagree with you.
Yeah, but okay, if you were trying to demonstrate in trust.
Would you say a feast on bananas?
No, because that's like that. I think that's really unfair.
I think you're just a bad loser. Okay. Number seven. What dried fruit is a prune?
A plume.
Did you both write this?
Yes.
Oh, well done, boys. You got that, lovely.
Oh, thank you very much.
Oh, Mrs. Don't fire me.
Yeah.
Have a lovely day.
And how do you say a plume in Hebrew?
You pronounce it like this, man. Like a shazif, Bob. I'm on a shazif.
A what?
Is it?
Shazif.
What are you talking about?
That's what a plume is in Hebrew.
You asked me to put plum in Hebrew, so it's a shazif.
Okay, fair enough.
So, guys, you learn two things every day. Shazif.
Number eight, the French term mange tout literally translates to what in English, Richard?
Eat everything.
And Shanga?
Well, Richard wrote
eat
what?
Everything. Oh, crap. Sugar snaps.
Well, it's eat all, so Shanga and Richard gets it right. Shanga gets a big fat zero.
Maybe you should get half a point.
No, because two is all or everything.
That's not fair. I don't speak French.
No, Richard gets a point and Shanga gets
fine. Jesus.
Number nine. What fruit is the main ingredient for a Melba sauce?
Richard wrote oil.
For fruit and veg. Round.
Pineapple.
The correct answer is raspberries.
What's it called? Melba sauce.
Melba sauce. I'm not going to lie.
I've never heard of a Melba sauce.
Number 10. What is the first vegetable to be grown in space, Richard?
Potatoes. That's what Shango wrote.
Oh. Richard wrote lettuce.
What? Richard, I thought this was
potato,
like...
Potato, man.
Bag.
Oh,
Why are you... Guys, round up the points. That is the end of the
round. Is it a potato, though?
It is a potato.
Come on, give it up, man.
Oh, Richard, I'm...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 out of 10,
Spudnik.
Richard.
Yeah. You like it? No.
Which goes towards your 20, which means you're on 26.
You're on 14, my dear fellow.
What?
Why is he doing so much?
I was on 19 the last time, so I'm on 14 now. 24.
Which is my minus his bitter points.
Yeah. So you got one more point from the. We got one more point than I did in this round, did you?
So what's
the final
score? See,
I got 5 out of 10, did I?
24 versus 26.
So Shank is on 24 and Richard is on 26.
It's all about the last round.
Guys, and guess what? Do you want to know the next round? Oh my god, yeah. It is.
It's like I know what
you're going
to say.
I mean, we've been working through this all evening for this.
It's a booze.
Boozy
booze!
Freaked me out. I could have
sworn
that I was just trying
to throw
off the table.
Yeah, you
look
we'll
like...
see you back in the booze round.
Yeah, guys, we'll see ya.
Booze round.
Wouldn't wanna be ya. Can I kick it? Can I kick it? Can I kick it?